you can't actually get money for your business. That's a bad day. When you cannot get business for your money, that is an absolute bad day, right? Good morning, everyone. Jeff Koga here. So I want to talk about how to overcome bad days. Now, in this episode of the podcast, if you're listening to the podcast or if you're watching this on video, I want to talk about how to overcome bad days. In this case, it's a real life example from yesterday. Now, I don't even like to use the term bad days because I'm so particular about the choices of words that I use, and a believer of how choices of words impact how we operate in the world, and to a point where I'll say that other people's choices of words or even my choices of words that I use is a direct reflection of who we are as an individual, right? So yesterday was really interesting. I got in early and I was just like, cool, we just started a new campaign. Right now, what do I mean by a new campaign? Is that we're transferring over our merchant account. Right now, our merchant processor and who we process our online payments for, the real estate education company that I have, we use Stripe and we use PayPal. Right now, nothing wrong with these companies, okay? Absolutely, they're great companies. PayPal, Stripe, great companies, made things so much easier to actually sell stuff online, okay? Don't get me wrong, all right? But when you get to a certain level, your KPIs, your key performance indicators, for tracking wise, you need a little bit more sophisticated type of tool, okay? Not only that, but when you start going over a certain amount of quote unquote sales, right? In the space of online selling, it's really dangerous if you only have like one merchant account. Why? Is because if they shut you off for whatever reason, then you're kind of screwed, right? So knowing that, I have literally like three Stripe account and I have two PayPal accounts, right? So that way I can take payments in different ways. But I was doing that, and I was doing this prior to actually bringing on the new CFO that I brought on last year, okay? And I've heard horror stories about merchant account, and especially like companies like Stripe, right? I've heard horror stories about like when you get over the actual 2-comma club, meaning you do over $1 million in sales, they'll typically shut you down. Okay, and why? Is because your payment processing that you're doing, it's not a dedicated like processing, you're mixed in with everyone else, okay? And they wanna actually alleviate the risk on the side of like chargebacks and fraud and stuff like that, right? So if you get over a certain amount of sale, they're gonna shut you off, okay? And I have heard horror stories, and I know friends of mine that actually only relied on Stripe only, and didn't have a backup, and literally it crushed them. Okay, so I knew that. So the last several years, I have like multiple Stripe account, right? So I can actually put, a couple hundred thousand there, a couple hundred thousand there, a couple hundred thousand there in the PayPal account in terms of sales. And I was purposely trying to keep it all under. And if I thought that I'm getting close to that actual top, I'll go ahead and just open up a new Stripe account. That was kind of my way that I was operating, right? But when you do that, the issue is it's hard to figure out the lifetime value of a customer. Okay, like as in how much is a customer worth, and how much of the dollar amount is it worth, and what the lifetime value of that customer is in terms of tracking, right? So we're running into a lot of that issue, especially when we brought on the new CFO, okay? So I'm giving the background because now we're switching over to a new processor, as in like a bank, and then from there using a gateway called Authorize.net. Now, Authorize.net, I used them years and years ago when I first started in online marketing and like selling stuff online, okay? So I open up an account, a new merchant account, and my CFO set up a gateway with Authorize.net like in January, and I haven't put a single transaction through, okay? Because I've been just so busy doing other stuff, right? So fast forward time now to where we're currently at, I was just like, nah, I have to change this over. I was supposed to finish this in Q1, so we did that. All right, now we created a new funnel, tested everything out, and I was like, cool, this is ready to rock and roll. And let me go ahead and send out a little test email, right? Maybe to about 5,000 people or so. So I sent out the email. Okay, now, when I say test, I mean like I literally got my own credit card and checked to see, put my own credit card in my own processing account to see if the upsells, downsells, and that kind of stuff works, and it was working fine. They actually charged the credit card, and not only that, but the payment got processed, and it got settled out, and boom, the merchant account actually wired our money back into our business checking account, right? So it was working, so like, cool, okay? So I sent out 5,000 emails or so, okay? And yesterday morning, we started seeing some sales. We're just like, oh, okay. Oh, the upsells are okay, cool. And I didn't think too much of it. And roughly about 3 p.m. or so, started discovering that, oh my gosh, you know what? Looking at the report, there was something called general error or something like that, that's what it said on there. And it was basically, I see the name of the people trying to buy. So I'm like, oh my gosh. So I hit up the guy who helped us set up this merchant account. I'm just like, dude, what's going on? He's in the East Coast. So keep in mind, it's like 3:30. So, you know, add 3 hours on, it's 6:30 their time. I don't get a call back from him. I'm like, damn it. You know, he didn't pick up. So I'm waiting. So I text him. He's texting me back. I'm shooting him like that. You know, I'm in chat support with Infusionsoft, chat support with Authorize.net. I'm trying to figure out what the heck is going on, and finally calls me back. I talk, and then he gives me the customer support number for the actual merchant processing. I call the merchant processing, and they're just like, oh no, we don't happen to have your information in our system. I'm like, wait, excuse me, how are you not having our information in our system? You know? And then come to find out I was calling the wrong phone number, so I had to call somewhere else. And long story short, the crap didn't work. So I was like, damn it, man. And the reason why that was kind of now a domino effect is because I was supposed to send out emails to test out another batch to for sales and make the funnel better, right? Because I'm trying to use this funnel for the media buys that I'm currently doing. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, man, this is supposed to be happening. So I'm on here. And then, you know, luckily enough with age, I guess you get a little bit more patient, right? Because I think if it was younger me, maybe even like 5 years ago or something like that, I would have got so pissed off. And I think I would have like literally started cussing people out, you know? Like, and that's, again, during that time, you can clearly see that's a direct reflection of who I am. And type of person I was years ago, and I become a lot patient, you know. So that was really bad, and I was just like, man. And you know, any single time that stuff is going on, right, I always ask myself, what's the silver lining? Because really, grand scheme of things, right, you're in the middle of a launch, technically like a soft launch, and it's not working. It's a bad day because you're trying to sell something, and the people want to buy, but they can't buy. That's a bad day in any business, right? Like, you can't actually get money for your business. That's a bad day. When you cannot get business for your money, that is an absolute bad day, right? So I was like, what's the silver lining in this? And I thought for a second, and I was just like, you know, the silver lining in this is, number one, I didn't hit the whole list of, like, you know, 200,000 people, and I sent it out, and, you know, all these people are trying to buy, but they couldn't buy, right? You know how bad that would have been, right? So that's number one. And then the other one is, I was just like, you know, this is something of, like, anything that I want to do online, I have to understand. Right? Because it's not just this real estate education company that I have. I also have an e-commerce business as well, and I need to understand that, because my e-commerce business is currently, right now, majority of my sales are coming from Amazon, but also at the same time, I'm shifting over to Shopify, and Shopify is back with Stripe too. So I was just like, man, like, it can happen the exact same thing. Right? So I was like, yeah, so that's a silver lining. And then I started researching in the Facebook groups. I started putting like keywords and try to find out like what was going on, because, you know, when I talked to my CFO afterwards, he was just like, yeah, you know, the one thing that I think might be happening is look, you got like at 7:45, that was your 10th transaction. And I should have counted this, but I didn't count it, right? So he counted it, and he was like, it was a 10th transaction. So if I had to guess, this is what he said, and I'll talk to them tomorrow about it, which is today. And he said, it might be an actual fraud detection or automatic shutoff, because we haven't used this account for almost like, you know, over 3 months, and suddenly we're trying to put transactions through, and they automatically shut it off. Right now, keep in mind, these charges aren't like thousands and thousands of dollars. It's only like, you know, 40 bucks, 100 bucks, you know, right? 200 bucks, 300 bucks, that kind of, you know, like small amounts of sales that we're trying to do. So on the 10th one, it shut it off. And then afterwards, he said that, and I was just like, okay, that might be it. So I ended up basically telling him, and says, hey, you know what? When you call them, let me be on the phone as well, so I can learn this back end process and how the merchant processing works, right? So that's number one. Another silver lining is that I'm gonna learn this side, because I have to know it. at least to an ability to be able to know where the problem is, right? Because I felt literally hopeless. Like if it was like a real estate stuff, right? Like literally, like I'm commander in chief when it comes to like, you know, hey, give me a problem in the real estate business, right? A deal's about to blow up, man. Like usually there hasn't been a problem, especially residential stuff, right? That I have not seen. And I can hop in and boom, I can figure out how to fix it as well as exactly who to call, what to do. And I can do figure out all that stuff. But like this stuff, I just didn't even know what to call, who to call, because I didn't understand any of this stuff, right? Like a V number. I didn't understand even gateways and stuff like that, right? Like I don't have, like I have a theoretical understanding of what a gateway is, but I don't have a deep understanding of how it is. So again, it was a bad day and I'm just trying to learn this. So again, silver lining is I'm gonna learn how to do it. I'm gonna learn how to understand what it is, or at least understand who to call, because again, I just didn't even know who to call, right? So if you're having a bad day, as I'm here in this office, right? I always do this, right? Number one, if I'm having a bad day, I'll try to fight through it and work a little bit harder, right, before the day is over. If it's really, really bad, right? Like yesterday wasn't that bad. I've been through more stuff worse than that, right? It wasn't like the terrible day. That's why I said bad day, right? So if it was a terrible day, I would have packed my stuff off, shut it off, and I would have went home and probably went to sleep early. And then I would have probably woke up like at 2 a.m., 3 a.m. and came to the office, right? So again, it's a bad day. I left, worked a little bit harder and got home maybe about 12:30, 1 o'clock, and went to sleep maybe like at 2:30. Because it took me a while to unwind, because I'm just like, man. And then I woke up and I'm in the office here as I'm doing this. I think it's like 6:15, I think, a.m. And that's kind of my routine. If I ever have a bad day or a terrible day, I try to show up the next day super earlier, as well as before I go home, I'll do a really, really detailed to-do, like a hit list, right? Like hit list that is something that I gotta hit and something I gotta finish, and that's what I did. And so my recommendation is, if you're having a bad day, right, is to do that. Don't just mope, don't just cry. Yeah, you know, if it's really terrible, right? I said bad, but if it's terrible, well, with all means, you know, you're allowed to mope, right? Maybe a day, you know, if you're stretching it, but beyond that, no. You know, if you're in a company, you don't got the right to do that. You don't got the right to mope. You don't got the right to cry. You just got to go ahead and get up and then get moving, right? And you got to get to work. So that's what I'm doing, and that's why I'm here. And then another stuff that kind of made it, you know, a bad day, you know, like as I said earlier, right? I don't even like that. Like it's a struggle for me to even articulate that it was a bad day, because I just don't even like to use that word. So it's hard for me to even articulate and tell the story, is because if I do that, I feel like I'm giving it power, right? So I'm like really trying to fight through it to even tell the story, because I'm so just like amped up and fired up to be like, let me go ahead and go kill it today, right? So other one is, there's supposed to be 4 closings in the real estate this week, and 2 of them got delayed. And I'm just like, damn it, man. You know, and it happens in real estate, right? With these closings, right? Certain things you just don't have control over. One of the two, the buyer's getting like cold feet right now. You know, they got their deposit in there. You know, we're wholesaling this, and so they got their deposit in there. So I'm just like, okay, you know, we might have to start scrambling to actually swap the buyer in this. This has simultaneously go back to the seller and maybe do a request for a price reduction too. So we're strategizing currently right now on that, and I'll let you know how it goes, because it was a thin deal, right? Like it's one of those like difficult deals, and I always tell people, like in the real estate game, right, I always say, hey, the marginal deals are always the most difficult ones to close. It takes away a lot of your bandwidth to actually close those. So that's what I got. So again, final thought on this: if you're the owner of the company and you're a business owner, or if you decide to be an entrepreneur, all right, you're gonna have bad days, all right? It's just given. You will have bad days, all right? And to a point where these bad days will even be considered terrible days, all right? But I challenge you not to even give it power by actually calling it a bad day or calling it a terrible day. Look for the silver lining on what happened, and look for the positive in that. And then if you have to, because it's so painful and it's such a terrible, terrible day, yes, you can get a couple of hours of moping, okay? You can mope, you can bitch, you can cry, okay? Maybe you can complain. Maybe if you have a friend that you can pick up the phone and call and you can actually vent to them, do that, okay? But then after that, all right, you just gotta shut up and just get to work and go fix the problem, right? That's it. That's all you gotta do. And really, that's the responsibility you have as the business owner. That's the responsibility you have as an entrepreneur. That's the responsibility that you have of building something that is going to be special and is going to give you the freedom that you want, right? Which is absolutely a business. Okay, so you got to suck it up and you got to go take out some fires. So that's what I got for you. Jeff Koga here. I'm taking off. I got to go take out some fires. Take care and bye-bye. We'll be right back.